In the past few years, we've had quite a bit of research come out that's helped us guide how we actually manage the land. And right now, we're really looking at a lot of the research on what we're going to do about reforestation and recovery efforts related to this tree mortality. We've lost over 300,000 acres of trees, and we know that we're not going to be able to put trees back everywhere on the landscape. It's just not feasible.
This level of mortality is shocking, but people should not be surprised, because our researchers and our land managers have agreed for quite a long time that this level of density, the number of trees we have, is out of character with a historic forest and predisposes it to this kind of event. When it comes to restoring forest structure, we work with scientists who look particularly at what the forest used to look like and also what the forest might need to look like in the future relative to climate variability.
Forests used to be composed of an incredible amount of variation. They were composed of groups of trees interspersed with gaps, lots of heterogeneity. We think that structure made the forest resilient to fire, and it probably also made it resilient to bark beetles.
This area that we're in at about 3,500 feet in elevation was typically a ponderosa pine forest. We know that this forest is going to actually transition into major brush fields, but without management, we will have chaparral fields just like we see in much of Southern California. That brush is going to outcompete those trees without us actually physically going in and removing brush continually until the trees can reach about, 30 years of age.
We're looking specifically at what adaptive strategies can we apply now going into the future to deal with this now very altered landscape. And so instead of just looking at, well, we're just going to restore everything, well, that may be possible, but it's also very expensive and we have limited resources. So how do we prioritize restoration and reforestation?
At this point in time, everything we're doing is still public safety. We are looking at the landscape, though, and how we're going to treat major watersheds to work toward reforestation efforts and hopefully recovery efforts. By knowing more about the physical features of the landscape itself and within the ground is where can we plant trees? Where do we think the trees are going to grow best?
We want to create a forest that's in sync, that is compatible with the water availability as well as what fire would have created in that forest historically. What does that mean? It means that you have places in the forest that are denser, that have larger clumps of trees, that have high canopy cover, but they're focused on places where you have a lot of water availability, so that the trees are reflective of that water availability, and those are places where you can have higher canopy cover and bigger trees. But if you move to another location that's much drier, let's say a southwest facing slope or steeper ground that doesn't hold as much water, in those kind of situations, you'd want to create a forest that's fairly low density, fairly open, dominated by species such as pine that can deal with the dry type of forest conditions.
We know that it's going to take a lot of work to get there, but much of the new research we're seeing is going to help us into the future. One of the things that we're working with the research station on that's really important right now is the identification of areas that we think are, we're going to hope will retain what little green trees are left on the landscape. And so we've had those conversations about how we can protect those little pockets of green trees. That's going to be our future large tree habitat. Those are going to be our old growth forests here pretty soon. So we're really working closely with them to define where those are on the landscape, how we can protect them and how we can grow them and keep them safe so we actually have habitat and green trees in the future.
What we've learned from monitoring the mortality in the Southern Sierras as part of our forest management activities is that density matters. How dense the forest is matters to relative to how trees survive this event. If you don't manage your tree density, if you don't manage in the face of increasing variability, then these events unfortunately will take its toll on our forests. What we've learned now needs to be translated into action and implementation on the ground, and we need to do that with a sense of urgency.
We know that this recovery effort is going to take a couple of generations. It takes generally 80 years at least to be able to grow big trees, so you may not see the forest that you're used to, but we're doing everything that we can and working with our research station and our partners and other non-governmental organizations to be able to get this forest into a recovery state.